Whether you're writing for Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, AdWords, Pinterest, or using mini blogs, it's important to deliver your message accurately and briefly. Social media marketing has exploded on the internet, and we've had to rethink the ways we word our advertisements and campaigns. With nearly 7.2 billion people living on Earth, it's been estimated that over 2 billion have social media accounts. That's a bit incomprehensible and daunting. Additionally, it gives us great pressure to make every word meaningful and impactful. So with that, I'd like to say it's good to see you again in this video of English for Marketing and Sales, where we'll be discussing concise language for social media marketing. We know shortening and abbreviating words in text messaging is very popular, but the best tip I can give you in social media marketing is don't do it. Use real words, real punctuation, real spelling, and good old-fashioned plain English. This presents an air of professionalism and power. With word count in mind, plenty of research shows that Facebook, Pinterest, LinkedIn, Instagram, Tumblr, or any social media site of your choosing receives more interest if the words are short and sweet. Twitter does this naturally by limiting the word count to 140 characters. In our daily digital, fast society, we've created humans with incredibly short attention spans. The next tip to make your words in social media marketing effective is to have a call for action. This could be to click on a link, to share a post, to retweet, to further read, or to download something. Let's take a look at this effective Twitter ad. It's punctuated properly, it gives you context of what it is, and it has a call for action to download the app. Plus, it's less than 140 characters. Facts, figures, and questions will also help with keeping interest on social media sites. It is also suggested that if you post a link, you shorten it using a site like Bitly. This not only makes the link easier and simpler for your mobile phone users, but it also tracks how many people click on the link. Okay, now let's talk about the power of our wording. The next tip is to write an active voice. Not only does this call your audience to action, but it makes your posts less wordy. With the active voice, your verbs or actions will be near the beginning of the sentence. Think of the action. What is happening? Or what do my customers need? Look at this. It's a very simple ad. But what do my customers need? Oh, it's clear. They need to spend $50 so they can get $10 off. Also, as Andrea explained, the picture is crisp and enticing. Papa John's Pizza started a mobile rewards program with the ad, "Earn Free Pizza Fast." This is written in the active voice. What can you do? It's answered at the beginning of the sentence. Here's what it would look like in a wordier fashion. Pizza can be gotten free by earning it. This is not effective or concise, and your customers will certainly lose interest. Plus, the ad is specific to what you get, pizza. It doesn't speak in generalizations like earn free gifts. Don't ever assume that your customers know because your name is Papa John's, you sell pizza. Another tip for concise language in social media marketing is to avoid run-on sentences or overstuff your sentences with too many facts, figures, extra adjectives, or as we call it, fluff. Think of Nike's slogan, just do it. Eliminate all words that aren't necessary. Think of vivid verbs. Doesn't return sound so much better than go back to? Or what about improved versus it got better? You try. Here's your sentence. There are several good reasons to buy this product. How can you make that phrase more concise? The last big tip for making your social media marketing short and effective, succinct and brief, is to write several drafts of your posts before hitting publish or send. One of the biggest complaints about social media is that most of the popular sites such as Facebook and Twitter have no edit buttons. Once you post, you're committed, and instantly the whole world can potentially know your thoughts. That's a lot of pressure, and you don't want to have any regrets. What are the takeaways from this lesson? First, use real words in plain English. Keep your messages short and sweet. Next, include a call for action. Use the active voice and vivid verbs. Avoid run-on sentences or cramming too much information in at once. And last, write several drafts before posting. Make sure your best work is what others see. For more tips on making language concise, please visit our first course, English for Management and Leadership, Lesson 5. I've really enjoyed this lesson in English for Marketing and Sales. I hope you have too. Goodbye for now.